Hi friends, welcome to Banik Smart Class. This is your probability chapter. If you want to learn the chapter probability, you have to watch the concept video of permutation and combination chapter. Without permutation and combination chapter, you cannot learn various things from the chapter probability. So these two chapters, permutation and combination chapters, are very very necessary for the probability chapter. So what is probability? Suppose you toss a coin. In one coin, there are two possibilities for head and another is tail. In one coin, you will get head and or tail. The probability of getting head, it is 1 by 2. The probability of getting tail, it is also 1 by 2. Probability of getting head, 1 by 2. Probability of getting tail, it is also 1 by 2. Clear? Probability of an event is denoted by probability of event, and is defined as PE is equal to probability of event is equal to number of event divided by number of samples. Number of event divided by number of samples. Probability of event is equal to number of event divided by number of samples. In the case of a coin, when you toss one coin, you will get two things. One is head, another is tail. Number of samples here, two. Maybe get, maybe head or maybe tail. But probability of event is equal to 1 here. Because we want to get head coin. Okay. That means only one head, that is your 1 by 2. So come to the another example. A dice is thrown. What is the probability that the number shown on the dice is an even number? Clear? So I make a dice. Okay? A dice is thrown. What is the probability that the number shown on the dice is an even number? In the dice, there are 6 numbers. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Even numbers are 2, 4, 6. There are 3 even numbers. And total number of dice is 6. Clear? So we select one even number. Even number means 3C1 divided by 6C1. NCR. In the combination chapter, you know NCR means N factorial divided by R factorial whole into N minus R factorial. So N factorial divided by R factorial whole into N minus R factorial. 3C1 means 3. If you put this formula, 3 factorial divided by 1 factorial, 3 minus 1, 2 factorial. So 3 into 2 into 1 divided by 1 into 2. So 2 into 1, 2 into 1 cancels. So we get here 3. Then 6C1 also 6. 3 by 6 means 1 by 2. So answer here 1 by 2. And even number answer 1 by 2. Clear? Then next number, an odd number. In the dice there are 3 odd numbers. How many odd numbers? 3 odd numbers. So from the 3 odd numbers we select a 1 odd number. 1 odd number means, that is your 3C1 divided by here 6C1. 3C1 means 3, 6C1 means 6, this is your 1 by 2. So an odd number, it is 1 by 2. Here, a number divisible by 2. A number divisible by 2. Okay? A number divisible by 2 means there are 6 numbers. In another way, in the question IIIA, a number divisible by 2 means it is the odd number. There are how many odd numbers? These are the odd numbers. Clear? 2, 4, 6. 3C1 divided by 6C1. 3C1 means 3, 6C1 means 6. This is your 1 by 2. 1 by 2. It is answer is 1 by 2. A number divisible by 3. The number which is divisible by 3 in the die is, these numbers are 3 and 6. Only 3 and 6, these two numbers are divisible by 3. Then I can write 2C1 divided by 6C1. 2C1 divided by 6C1. 2C1 means 2, 6C1 means 6. 2 by 6 is equal to 1 by 3. This is the answer, 1 by 3. A number less than 4. A number less than 4 means, there are only 3 numbers. There are only 3 numbers. Less than 4, there are only 3 numbers. So, 3C1 divided by 6C1. This is your also 1 by 2. This answer, a number less than 4, 1 by 2. V answer 1 by 2. Then come to the VI, a number less than or equal to 4. Less than or equal to 4 means there are 4 numbers. 4C1 divided by 6C1. 4C1 means 4 divided by 6. If you cancel this number, 2 to 2, 2 to 3, 2 by 3. This answer 2 by 3. A number greater than 6. Greater than 6, there are no number in the dice. The answer is what? 0. A number less than or equal to 6. Less than or equal to 6 means 6 by 6 is equal to 1. Clear? Then come to the next example. Example number 2. Try to understand the probability. Probability of events is equal to number of desired events divided by number of total events. Clear? In a box carrying 1 dozen mangoes. 1 dozen mangoes means 12 mangoes. Twelve oranges. One third have become bad. 12, it's one third, 4 bad oranges. The remaining 12 minus 4 is equal to 8 good oranges. Okay. If 3 oranges are taken out from the box at random, what is the probability that at least 1 orange out of the 3 oranges picked up is good? At least 1 orange out of the 3 oranges picked up is good. There are 12 oranges. 12C3. There are 12 oranges. We have to pick 3 oranges randomly. So that number of samples here 12C3. In the 12C3, when you pick 3 oranges, in the 3 oranges all are good. Or in the 3 oranges all are bad. Or in the 3 oranges, 2 are good and 1 is bad. 1 is good and 2 are bad. Okay, clear what I say? So 12C3, you can select any 3 oranges. From good oranges, from bad oranges, from good bad oranges. Clear? But probability that at least 1 orange out of the 3 oranges picked up is good. At least 1 orange out of the 3 oranges picked up is good. Okay? So, in this question, we select 3 oranges. In this question, we select 3 oranges. Only bad oranges. How many bad oranges here? There are 4 bad oranges. What? There are 4 bad oranges. We select only 3 oranges. 4C3 from the bad 4 oranges. We select 3 oranges from the 4 oranges. Bad oranges. That is your 4C3. You know that 4C3 is equal to 4. Then 12C3. 12C3 means 12 factorial divided by 3 factorial into 9 factorial. That means 12 into 11 into 10 into 9 factorial divided by 3 into 2 into 1 into 9 factorial. This 9 factorial cancels. 3 to the 6 to the 12. 11 to the 22, 10 to the 220. 220 means 1 by 55. Okay. But questions to me, sir. This is the question, at least one orange out of the three orange picked up is good. But you find here, all the three orange are bad. All the three orange are bad. But it's 55. There are 55 chances. There are 55 chances to pick up the good. To pick up the orange. Good orange, bad orange, or good bad orange, or bad good orange. Clear? But one is the only bad orange. Then if you subtract 1 minus 1 by 55, the chances it is your 54 by 55. At least 1 is good here. There are 54 chances, at least 1 is good. At least 1 is good, 2 is good or 3 is good. Clear what I say? In another way, question number 3. Out of 15 students studying in a class, 7 are from Maharashtra, 5 are from Karnataka and 3 are from Goa. 4 students are to be selected at random. What are the chances that at least one is from Karnataka? The question number 2 and question number 3, there are no difference. Same logic you can be applied and you will get your answer. So there are 15 students, total number of students 15. 4 students are to be selected. 4 students are to be selected. That means the number of samples 15 C 4. 15 C 4. Then 7 are from Maharashtra, 5 are from Karnataka, then 3 are from Goa, Karnataka, 3 are from Goa. Clear? What are the chances that at least one is from Karnataka? At least one is from Karnataka. If there are no Karnataka, we cannot accept. Clear? If there are no Karnataka, in which group? In the four students. If there are no Karnataka, we cannot accept in our question. Clear? So, Karnataka means 7 plus 3, 10, 10 C4. 1 minus 10 C4 by 15 C4, we get the answer. So 10 C4 means 10 factorial divided by 4 factorial into 6 factorial divided by 15 C4, 15 factorial divided by 4 into 15 minus 4, 11 factorial. 10 into 9 into 8 into 7, 4 factorial divided by 15 into 14 into 13 into 12 into 11 factorial divided by 4 factorial. 4 factorial cancels. Then 5 2 ja, 5 3 ja. Then 3 ja, clear. 3 to 6, 6 to 12. Then 7 2, 2 to 4, 4 to 8, 2 by 13. 2 by 13. 1 minus 2 by 13, that is your answer, 11 by 13. 11 by 13, it is your correct answer. Come to the next number. Question number 4. A bag contains 5 blue and 4 black balls. 3 balls run at random. What is the probability that 3 are blue? So here total number of balls, 5 blue balls and 4 black balls. Total number of blue and black, sum is 9. Then 3 balls are drawn. That is your 9C3. Then, what is the probability that 3 are blue? There are 5 blue balls, 5C3. 5C3 means 5 factorial divided by 3 factorial into 2 factorial. Then 9C3 means 9 factorial divided by 3 factorial into 6 factorial. So here, 5 into 4 into 3 factorial divided by 3 factorial into 2 divided by 9 into 8 into 7 into 6 factorial divided by 3 into 2 into 1 into 6 factorial. This is 6 factorial cancels and 3 factorial 2 ja, 5 2 ja 10 divided by here 3 ja 9 then 2 4 ja. 4 3 ja 12 7 ja 18 4. 10 by 84 means 2 5 ja then 2 4 5 by 42. Answer it is your 5 by 42. Come to the next number, question number 5. A or contains 9 red, 7 white and 4 black balls. A ball is drawn at random. What is the probability that the ball drawn is not red? So here 9 red balls, 7 white balls, 4 black balls, 9 plus 7, 16, 4 plus 4, 20, 20 is 1. And what is the probability that the ball drawn is not red? Is it not red means the other colors are 7 and 4. 7 plus 4, 11, 11 C1. 11 C1 means 11. 20 C1 means 20. This answer is 11 by 20. 5 answer 11 by 20. Clear? Come to the next number. What is the chance that a leap year selected randomly? We have 53 Sundays. Okay? What is the chance that a leap year selected randomly will have 53 Sundays? Leap year. In ordinary year, it is 366 days. Okay? 366, how many weeks? In 1 week, there are 7 days. So divided by 7 per week. 7, 5 is a 35, then 16, 7, 2 is a 14, 2. So, 52 weeks in one leap year, we get 52 weeks, 2 odd day. 52 weeks, 2 odd day. Okay. What is the chance that a leap year selected randomly will have 53 Sundays? 2 odd day, 52 weeks, 2 odd day. 2 odd days means one is Sunday, then another is Monday. Then Monday, Tuesday, then Tuesday, Wednesday, then Wednesday, Thursday, then Friday, then Friday, okay, Saturday and Sunday. So here we get 2 Sundays, clear? But there are number of chances, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, there are 7 chances. We get only 2 Sunday, the probability of Sundays for the 53 Sunday, that is your 2 by 7. This sum 7 is the total chances of Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday. There are 7 chances. From the 7 chances, we get only 2 chances in Sunday. So I write 2 by 7. What is the chance if the year selected is not a leap year? First question 2 by 7. First question answer 2 by 7. Come to the second question. What is the chance if the year selected is not a leap year? If the year is not a leap year, there are 52 weeks in one odd day. 52 weeks in one odd day. This odd day is Sunday, maybe Sunday. Or Monday, then Tuesday, Wednesday, then Thursday, Friday, then Saturday. Clear? Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday. There are 7 chances. But only we get one Sunday. We get only one Sunday. In the ordinary year, the probability of Sundays for 53 Sundays in 1 year, that is your 1 by 7. Second question answer, double I question answer 1 by 7. First question answer 2 by 7. Clear? Come to the next number. Question number 7. When 2 dice are thrown, what is the probability that sum of numbers appeared is 6 and 7? Sum of a number appeared is less than equal to 8. Sum of a number is an odd number. Sum of a number is a multiple of 3. Numbers shown are equal. The difference of the number is 2. Sum of the numbers is at least 5. All these questions are very easy questions, but you have to learn the fundamental tricks. If you know the fundamental tricks or conceptual tricks of the dice, then this question maximum to maximum needs 2 minutes, not 2 minutes, less than 2 minutes also. Come to the question. when two dice are thrown, when two dice are thrown, total number of samples, total number of samples, number of samples is 36. Here, 6 square, 36. Sum of numbers appeared is 6 and 7. Okay? Sum of numbers appeared is 6 and 7. Total number of samples here, 36. Two dice. When you throw two dice, what are the chances to get a two? The sum of the numbers of the two dice. Are you clear what I say? Suppose you throw two dice. What are the chances that sum of the two numbers of the two dice will be one? So here only one and one. If you throw the two dice in one dice, in the first dice you get one, and in the second dice if you get one, then sum of the two dice number 1 plus 1, 2. The chances is only 1. When you want to sum is 3. 3 means in the first dice 1, second dice 2, 2, 1, 3. Then first dice 2 and second dice 1, 3. Suppose 4, that is your 2, 2 and 3, 1, 1, 3. This chance is what? 3 chances. And 3, this is 2 chances. And 2, it is your 1 chances. Clear? Then 5. 5 means 4, 1. 1, 4. 2, 3. 3, 2. This is your 4 chances. Then 6. 5, 1. 1, 5. 2, 4. 4, 2. 3, 3. There are 5 chances. Then 7. Suppose I write here 7. 7 means 6, 1, 1, 6, 5, 2, 2, 5, sorry, 2, 5, 4, 3, 3, 4. This chances is what? 6. Then come to the 8. In the 8, 3, 5, 5, 3, 4, 4, 6, 2, 2, 6, 5. Then come to the 9. 9 means 6 plus 3, 9. Then 3, 6, 9. 5, 4, 9, 4, 5, 9, 10, only 5, 5, then 4, 6, 6, 4, sorry, 4, 6, and 6, 4, there are 3 chances, okay, 9, it is 4 chances, 11, there are 2 chances, what are the chances, 6, 5, and 5, 6, 12, only 1 chances, that is your 6 and 6, try to understand this concept. When you find the sum of the two dice number is 2, there are only one chance. In the first dice you will get 1, in the second dice you will get 1, the sum of the two dice is 2, that chances is 1. If you find out the sum is 3, the chances is 2, 2, 1, 1, 2, there are two chances you will get the 3, sum of the two dice. Are you clear what I say? But here 4 means you will get only 3 chances, that there are chances 2, 2, 3, 1 and 1, 3. 5, something 4, 1, 1, 4 and 2, 3, 3, 2. Okay, there are 4 chances. 6, there are 6 chances, 5 chances. 7, you will get here 6 chances. 8, you will get here 5 chances. 9, 4, 10, 3, 11, 2, 12, 1. Listen, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay, clear? Come to the question. Sum of numbers is appeared is 6 and 7. Sum is 6, the chances is 5 here. 6, 5 by that is 6. Plus, sum is 7. 7 means the chances is here 6. So I write here 6 by that is 6. 5 by that is 6 plus 6 by that is 6 is equal to 11 by that is 6. Option I answer 11 by 36. Clear? Come to the next number, question number 2. Sum of numbers appeared is less than equal to 8. Less than equal to 8. Less than equal to 8 means 5, 8. You will find the 8 sum of the 2 dice, the chances is 5. In the 7, 6 chances. In the 6, 5 chances. In the 5, 4 chances. In the 4, 3. For the 3, 2 and 1. These are the chances and 1. So here 6, 5, 11, 11, 5, 11, 5, 16, 16, 4, 20, 20 plus 3, 23, 23, 2, 25. 6, 5, 11, 5, 16. 6, 5, 11, 5, 16, 16 plus 4, 20, 20 plus 3, 23, 23, 2, 25, 25, 1, 26. 26 by 36. Okay. 2, 13, 2, 18. 13 by 18. The number of chances, question number 2, double I answer, 13 by 18. Clear? Then come to the next number, question number 3. The sum of a number is an odd number. Odd number means 3. Okay. Odd numbers are 3, 5. Okay. Then 7. Then 9. Then 11. 3, you will get 2 chances. And 5, 4. And 7, 6. 9, 4. 11, 2. So 4, 2, 6, 6, 12. 12 for 16 to 18. 18 by 36. 18 by 36 means this answer here. 1 by 2. 18 by 36, if you cancel this number, you will get 1 by 2. Sum of numbers is a multiple of 3. Multiple of 3. Multiple of 3 means 1 is 3, another is 6, 9, 12. 3, 6, 9, 12. 3 there are chances 2. 6 there are chances 5. 9 there are chances 4. Clear? Then 12, this chances is only 1. 4, 1, 5, 5, 5, 10 to 12, 12 by 36, 12 by 36, it is your answer, 12 by 36, 1 by 3, IV answer 1 by 3, clear? Numbers shown are equal, numbers shown are equal, how many chances here? There are 6 chances, how do you get 6 chances? Because 2, 2, 3, 3, 4, 4, 5, 5, 6, 6 and also 1, 1. 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 4, 4, 5, 5, 6, 6. There are 6 chances. 6 by 36. 6 by 36 means 1 by 6. Clear? The difference of the number is 2. The difference of the number is 2. The difference of the number is 2. 6, 4, 4, 6. Then 5, 3, 3, 5. Okay. Then 4, 2. 2, 4, then 3, 1, 1, 3, these are the chances, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 8 by 36, so option VI answer 8 by 36, clear, 6, 4, 4, 6, 5, 3, 3, 5, 4, 2, 2, 4, 3, 1, then 2, 3, no, 4, 2, correct answer, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 8 by 36. 8 by 36, if you cancel this number, 4 2 ja, then 4 9 ja. 2 by 9. The answer, the difference of the number is 2. The probability is 2 by 9. Question number, next number. Question number V double I. Last. Question number V double I. Sum of the numbers is at least 5. At least 5 means this is your 5. At least 5 means you added these numbers. 4, 3, 7, 7, 2, 9, 9, 1, 10. 10 by 36. 10 by 36 means 2, 5 is 2, 18. Okay. If you find the sum of the 2 dice number is 2, then chances is 1. If you find the sum of the 2 dice number is 3, then chances is 2. Then sum of the 2 dice number is 4, chances is 5. Then 5 is 4. You added this number 4 plus 3, 9, 9, 4 plus 3, 7, 7, 2, 9, 9, 1, 10. 10 by 36. Answer it is your 5 by 18. Clear? Come to the next number. From a pack of 52 cards, 2 cards are drawn at random. What is the probability that it has both of the S? At first, we have to clear about the card. The total number of cards here 52. Total number of cards here 52. Clear? From the 52 cards, there are 26 cards red suits. Then 26 cards black suit. So 26 cards black suit. Thank you. In the red suit, what is it? Diamond. Another is heart. In the diamond, 13 cards, heart also 13 cards. In the diamond, you will get a digit letter cards A, J, K, Q. Letter cards. A, J, K, Q. That means letter cards number is 4. Then digit cards are 9. Clear? Digit cards are 9. It is your letter card. A, J, K, Q, 4. Digit cards here 9. Then 13. Here also A, J, Q, K, 4. Letter card. And a 9 digit cards. In the 26 cards also 13 clock card, 13 are clock card and a 13 spade card. Clear? In the clock card 4 are letter cards, 9 are digit card. In the 13 4 are letter cards and a 9 are digit cards. Clear? So come to the question. These are the card, 52 cards, total cards, number of cards are 52. From the 52 cards, we get 26 cards are red suits and 26 cards are black suits. In the 26 red suits card, diamond 13, heart 13. In the black suit card, 13 club and 13 spade. In the 13 number of cards, A, J, K, Q, it is called a letter card or honors card. These are also called honors card. Letter card. Are you clear? Then the rest of the numbers, 13 minus 4 is equal to 9. 9 cards are digit cards. In the digit means 2, 3, 5, 7, 8. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. These are the 9 letter, line, 9 digit cards. Okay, clear? Come to the question. From a pack of 52 cards, 2 cards are drawn. 2 cards are drawn at random. What is the probability that it has both the S? S means you will get in each group 1 S. So, in the diamond A, 1 card is available. In the hat, it is also 1 card is available. In the black, A also available. In the spade, A also available. So there are 4 S cards. How much cards of S? 4. So 4C2 divided by 52C2. Total number of chances here 52C2. 4C2 means? 4C2 means you have to select the 2 cards from the S card. Here. 4C2 means I can write 4 into 3 divided by 2. 52C means 52 into 51. Divided by 2. 2 cancels. 2 2 ja 2 26. Okay. 3 2 ja 3 17. Then 2 13. That means 1 divided by 13 7 ja 91. 1 19 carry. 13 1 ja 13. 13 9. 22. Okay. 1 by 221. Question number I answer. 1 by 221. Clear? Come to the next number. Question 2. Exactly 1 queen. Exactly 1 queen. In the total card, we get 4 queens. How much queen you get? 4 queens. In each 13 card, we get only 1 queen. We get also in diamond 1 queen. In a hat, also we get queen. In the club, we get a queen. In the spade, we get a queen. There are 4 queens. Exactly 1 queen, 4C1. Divided by total number of cards, 52. We have to select the 2 cards. So, 52C2 into... Try to understand exactly 1 queen. Total number of cards here, 52. How much total number of cards? 52. In the 52 cards, there are 4... queen cards. The rest of the cards here, 52 minus 4 is equal to 48. We have to select one card from the 48 cards. This is your 48, this is 1. This is 1 queen card, then other card will be 1. So 4C1 into 48 C1 divided by 52 C2. 4C1 means 4. 48 C1 means 48 divided by 52 C2. 52 into 51 divided by 2 means it is 26. Then 2 2s are 4. Then 2 13. Then 3 here 16. Then 3 17. 16 2s are 32 divided by 13 into 17, 221. 32 by 221, option, double I answer, exactly one to get the answer, 32 by 221. Come to the next number, no honors card. Here, no honors card means, in each group, we get 4 honors card, AJ, QK. These are the 4 honors card. Here we get 4 honors card. In each group we get 4 honors card. In the red suit, 4 honors card, 4 and 4 honors card, there are 4 for 8, 8 for 12 for 16, there are 16 honors card. The total number of cards is 52. We get the 16 honors card, 12 minus 6 is equal to 6, 4 minus 1 is equal to 3, 36 honors card. So, 2 cards are drawn. 36 is C2, no honors card means we select 2 cards from the other cards. 36 is C2 divided by 52 C2. 36 is C2 means 36 into 35 divided by 2. 52 C means 52 into 51 divided by 2. 2 cancels. 2 18, then 2 26, then 3 6, then 3 17, then 2 3, then 2 13. 17 into 13, it is your 221. Then 35 into 3 is equal to 105. The answer is 105 by 221. Triple I answer 105 by 221. Then come to the no digit card. No digit card. So here, in the no digit card concept, in each group there are 9 digit cards. Here 9 digit cards, here 9, and these are the total 9, 9, 9, 9, 4, 9. 9, 4 are 36 cards. Then 36 cards. No digit card means we have to select from the honors card. In each group we know that there are 4 honors card. 4, 4, 4, 4. There are 4. There are 4 fours, that means 4 for 8, 8 for 12, 4 16, there are 16 honors card. I can write here 16 C2 divided by 52 C2. 16 C2 divided by 52 C2. 16 into 15 divided by 2, then divided by 52 into 51 divided by 2. This 2 cancels, then 3 5 is a 3 17 is a. Then 4 4 ja, then 4 13 ja, 5 4 ja 20, 20 by 13 into 17, 221. So 20 by 221, no digit card, option IV, question IV answer 220, 20 by 221. The last question, one king and one queen. One king and one queen. You know that in the pack of 52 cards, there are 4 king and 4 queen. 4 king and 4 queen. 1 king and 1 queen. That is your 4C1 into 4C1. 4C1 into 4C1 divided by 52C2. 4C1 means 4. 4C1 means 4. Divided by 52C2, 52 into 51 divided by 2, 2 means it is 26, okay, 26 means 4, 2 2 4, 2, 13, then 4 2 8 divided by 13 1 13, 3 1 carry, 13 5 65 plus 1, 66. 8 by 663. Correct answer. Come to the next number. A bag contains 3 red, 5 yellow and 4 green balls. 3 balls are drawn random. What is the probability that the balls drawn contain balls of different colors? We have to find out the different colors probability. So there are 3 red and 5 yellow, 4 green balls. 3 balls are drawn at random. Total number of balls? 5, 4, 9, 3, 12. We have to select 3 balls. That is your 12C3. What is the probability that the balls don't contain balls of different colors? Different colors means 3C1 into 5C1 into 4C1. 3C1 means 3, 5C1 5, 4C1 4, divided by 12C3. 12 factorial divided by 12, 3 factorial into 9 factorial. So I can write 12 into 11 into 10 into 9 factorial divided by 3 into 2 into 1. 3 to 6 to 11 to 22 into 10, 220. 220 means 5, 4 to 20, 44. 4 means it is 11. That answer is 3 by 11. The answer is here 3 by 11. Then come to the next number, question number 10. So here 6 into 2, 12 by 55. The answer is your 12 by 55. 6 into 2, 12 by 55. Here, come to the next number, 11 number. A bag contains 3 red, 5 yellow, 4 green balls. 3 red, 5 yellow, and 4 green balls. 3 total number of balls, 4, 5, 9, 10, 12. 3 balls are drawn randomly, number of samples here, 12, see 3. What is the probability that the balls don't contain no yellow ball? No yellow ball means the rest of the number 4 plus 3 7. That means 7 C3. 7 C3 by 12 C3. 7 C3 by 12 C3. You know that 7 C3 means 7 into 6 into 7 factorial divided by 7 factorial divided by 3 factorial into 4 factorial and a 12 factorial divided by 3 factorial into 9 factorial. So 7 means 7 into 6 into 5 into 4 factorial divided by 3 into 2 into 1 into 4 factorial. They cancel, 3 to 1, 6, 6 cancels. Divided by 12 into 11 into 10 into 9 factorial, 9 factorial cancels. This is 3 into 2 into 1. 3 to 6 to 12. 11 to 22, 220. Then 7 5 is 35. 5 7 is 544, 7 by 44. Answer, it is your 7 by 44. Clear? There are 4 boys and 4 girls. They sit in a row randomly. What is the chance that all the girls do not sit together? What is the chance that all the girls do not sit together? It is your permutation question. There are 4 boys and 4 girls. Number of persons here 8. If they sit in a row, there are 8 factorial ways they can be seen. The probability, the total number of samples here 8 factorial. But question, what is the chance that all the girls do not sit together? Suppose all the girls do not sit together. You know that when question comes to not sit together, at first we have to take sit together. If the girls are sit together, 4 boys and 4 girls. These are the boys, 4 boys. These are the girls. These 4 girls we consider is 1. And 4 boys, 1, 2, 3, 4 at 1, 5. 5 factorial into 4 factorial. 5 factorial into 4 factorial, it is sitting together. 1 minus 5 factorial into 4 factorial divided by 8 factorial, we get not sitting together. That means 1 minus 5 factorial 5 factorial into 4 factorial means 4 into 3 into 2 into 1 divided by 8 factorial means 8 into 7 into 6 into 5 factorial. This 5 factorial cancels. 3 to the 6, 6 cancels. 4 to the 1 minus 1 by 14. The answer is what? 13 by 14. Answer it is your 13 by 14. Clear? Try to understand the concept of these questions. These are the very important questions for your exam. If you clear about your concept only, I discuss these questions through the concept. Make a note and practice again and again this which logic is applied in the which question. There are 4 to 5 logics you find in this chapter probability. Okay, if you practice again and again this logic, definitely it will be very easy to solve these types of questions. Okay, come to the next number, question number 13. A box contains 4 black balls, 3 red balls and 5 green balls. When you read the question, at first we have to find out the number of samples and a number of chances of probability. These are the very 2 basic things to find the answer. So here 4 black balls. And 3 red balls. And 5 green balls. 2 balls are drawn from the box at random. What is the probability that both of the balls are the same color? Both of the balls are the same color. Suppose you select black ball, 4C2 divided by 4 plus 3, 7, 5, 12 C2. This is one chance to select the same color of a black ball. And come to the red, this chance is 3C2 divided by 12 C2. And 5C2 divided by 12 C2. We added the total number of chances. 4C2 divided by 12C2 plus 3C2 divided by 12C2 plus 5C2 divided by 12C2. 4C2 means 4 into 3 divided by 2. 2 to the 3 to the 6 plus 3C2 means 3 plus 5C2 means 5 into 4 divided by 2. 2 to the 5 to the 10. 12C2. 12C2 means 12. Into 11 divided by 2, 2, 6, 11, 6, 66. 69, 9 plus 10, 19. 19 by 66. Answer it is your 19 by 66. Clear? A bag contains 5 red and 8 black balls. 2 draws of 3 balls each are made. The ball being replaced after the first draw. What is the chance that the balls were red in the first draw and black in the second? A bag contains 5 red and 8 black balls. 2 draws of 3 balls each are made. The ball being replaced after the first draw. This is a very important question. Try to understand this question. 2 draws of 3 balls each are made. What is that meaning? You have to select 3 balls but only for 2 times. In the first time you draw red ball. In the second time you draw white ball. So come to the 5C3, first time you can draw 5C3 by 13C3 into second time 8C3 by 13C3. But in this question, 2 draws of 3 balls, this is the first draw and second draw. These are 2 draws of 3 balls each are made without being replaced. So the 5C3 means 5 factorial divided by 3 factorial into 2 factorial. That means 5 into 4 divided by 2, 2 to the 5 to the 10 into 8C3 means 8 factorial divided by 3 factorial into 5 factorial. So 8 into 7 into 6 into 5 factorial divided by 3 into 2 into 1 into 5 factorial cancels. 3 to the 6 is cancels. 8 7 the 56. Okay. 8 7 the 56. 56 into 10 divided by 13C3. 13 into 12 into 11 into divided by 3 factorial into 10 factorial into 10 factorial. This 10 10 cancels. 3 factorial means 13 into 12 into 11 divided by 3 into 2 into 1. 3 to the 6 to the 13 into 26 into 11. So here 13 C3 26 into 11. So 2 5 is a then 213, then 228, then it is 13. So 28 into 5, 140 divided by 13, 169, 11 into 11. So 140 divided by 11, 99 carry, 11, 6, 66 plus 9, 75, 57 carry, 11, 1, 11, 7, 18, 185, 9 into 11. 140, 11, 9, 99, 99 carry, 11, 5, 55 plus 9, 64, 46 carry. Then 11, 8, 88 plus 6, 94, 49 carry. 11, 1, 11 plus 9, 20449. 140 by 20449, it is your answer. Clear? Come to the next number. A bag contains 5 black and 7 white balls. A ball is thrown out of it and replaced in the bag. Then a ball is drawn again. What is the probability that there are 5 black balls and a 7 white balls? A ball is drawn again. That is your 5C1 by 12C1 into 7C1 by 12C1. 5C1 means 5 by 12 into 7C1, 7 by 12. This is your 35 by 140. Both the balls thrown away are black. Sorry, both of the balls thrown away are black. Then 5C1 by 12C1 into 5C1 by 12C1. 5C1 by 12C1, 5 by 12 into 5 by 12. 5 by 12 into 5 by 12 is 25 by 144. 25 by 144, I answer. 25 by 144. Then come to the next number. Both way are white. Both way are white means there are 7 white balls. So 7 white balls means I can write here 7C1 by 12C1 into 7C1 by 12C1. That means 7 by 12 into 7 by 12. 49 by 144. 49 by 144 double I answer. Then next number, question number 3. The first ball was white. First ball was white means 7 white balls. 7C1 by 12C1. Into the second black, 5C1 by 12C1. So here, 7 by 12 into 5 by 12. 35 by 140. The first ball was black. First ball was black means 5C1 by 12C1 into. Second is white, 7C1 by 12C1. 5 by 12 into 7 by 12 is equal to 35 by 140. Clear? This is your probability chapter. Try to make a note of these questions and practice again and again. If you have any doubts or assignments, then come to the doubt clearing class. We will discuss all your doubts. Okay, thank you very much. Bye.